On the way to Lo Monthang is a hidden cave where deities are said to emanate from the walls. Buddhists come here on pilgrimage to see if they can make out the human-like forms. An old lama who escaped Tibet is the caretaker of the cave. He explains that those who can see the deities are closer to reaching enlightenment.
The people who have the highest development can see everything as deities. And people who are low in spiritual practice cannot see anything.
To the believer, some 50 human-like figures seem to emerge from the cave walls, where there's no obvious evidence of tool marks. For Buddhists, these are not mere objects. They are believed to transmit a living presence. On a high pass at 13,000 feet, the view of Tibet is just beyond the distant hills, its border guarded by the Chinese. This is the first time Lama Guru has seen Tibet in years. Stringing prayer flags will send words of compassion toward his homeland. An ancient practice that has lasted 1,000 years, pressing prayers onto cloth, is the earliest form of printing in the Himalaya. The five elemental colors represent sky, cloud, fire, water, and earth. And each prayer is believed to take flight on the heels of Lungta, the wind horse, who dispatches his messages in the four sacred directions. In the valley below, Lo Monthang, the forbidden royal city, the kingdom's crown jewel, an oasis in the high desert. As in medieval times, the two great monasteries of Lo, painted in red, stand out against the surrounding houses. For 5 centuries, the 30-foot walls enclosing the city have kept out unwanted visitors. In its heyday, Lo Monthang's wealth was legend, and so was its first ruler, a Tibetan warlord whose imposing white palace still houses his direct descendant, the king of Mustang. Mustang's early kings built the greatest monasteries of the land, Thubchen and Champa. They summoned the most celebrated artists of the day to adorn this sacred space.
The kings were very religious. They were very great in preserving the tradition and culture. That was the most glorious time of the Mustang era.
Over 500 years ago, the monks from Tibet were attracted to Lo's great monasteries. Thubchen became a center of religious education for monks who memorized religious books and studied logic and philosophy.
Monasteries are the basis, or let us say the essence, of a Tibetan culture. They initiate a lot of social works for educating the young children and also look after the welfare of the whole community. That is the life force of the culture.
But today, the life force is dying out. Gathered around Lama Guru for picture taking is a tiny community of 70 lamas and students. It's a far cry from the religious complex of 1,000 monks that used to exist here. They're headed by the Kempo, the abbot of the monasteries of Lo. Lama Guru receives a blessing from the Kempo to enter Thubchen Monastery for the first time. For Buddhists, the statues and paintings here are as real as the images they signify. Gleaming amidst the ruins is a statue of Lord Buddha, a founder of the Buddhist faith.
To come here is a dream. I was really amazed how the Buddhism has flourished in this region 500 years ago. But we are really sorry to find how things has been damaged. Condition is quite grim.
Seventeen images of the Buddha and his attendants peer out from behind the grime. To the people, these are living deities, trapped behind a veil of soot. Entire pieces of the gods are missing, where water has poured in from the outside. The damage is so extensive, it obscures the greatness of the art, even to the experienced eye of architect John Sanday.
When I walked in for the first time, I was very aware of the damage. It was only later on that I began to realize how fantastic the wall paintings actually were. They're 15th century, they're priceless. These are masterpieces.